prachar, vichar, krishi, prakriti, innumerable things are there. These divisions now we are seeing, National Geographic Channel, what is it? It is prakriti, krishi channel is there, krishi divisions are there, Kali sports channels are there, Adhyatma channel, Samskarastra channels are there. So whatever we are seeing now, these are all common divisions of the society and the social or societal taste catering to which they have been made. And what is the phala and what is the present contemporary nishpala or futility? The utility of these channels are darshana, bodhana, protsahana, shamana, prerana. They are known as panchanga or panchopaya. There are five major reasons for which we are doing all of these things. First thing is darshana. We are showing a lot of things. For what purpose? Bodhana, to educate them. What is the type of education? Prerana, to direct them in the right path. Shamana, to settle or extinguish or extirpate the unwanted vibrations or unwanted connotations inside their mind. And the fifth thing is protsahana, to keep them always energetic, by which they can achieve the things. That is why it is known as recreation. Anybody, those who are already creative, their creativity is obstructed by means of their exhaustion. That energy loss is compensated by a process of recreation, by which they are compensated, they are complemented, they are compassionately embraced by means of a vital induction, by which they effectively do the work 10 times more than the productivity which they have been working. But that is not now. With the present media industry, it is acting in a different way. Kriyahari, buddhihari, and kalahari. It is a voracious consumer of time. It is a criminal waste of time. So it is kalahari. It totally corrupts the human intellect and mind. That's why it is known as buddhihari and kriyahari. It does not energize your work. Totally your work level or the performance grade or rate of your success will be spoiled or diminished. That is the present media. Because of lack of few things. What is that? Standard of reality and recreation. What is reality and what is recreation? How far they can be implemented? I want to put five golden rules for media industry. Number one, media, there is one taste. You know that there is a taste bud. In your tongue, there is a consumptive taste bud. Likewise, in your mind, there is an aesthetic taste bud. The duty of the media is to lead the society's aesthetic taste bud to a proper direction, not to feed their aesthetic taste buds. If you feed their aesthetic taste buds, whatever they like, then the society will be corrupt and collapse. No doubt you can develop, but not the society. Your development is at the cost of sacrificing the values of the society. So lead the society, don't feed the society. They are too immature to ask or to select what they want and what that is good for them. They are very immature. So feed the society by means of which you can lead them. Don't just feed them as per the taste. That is the first rule. Second thing is, there are three vices or antagonistic factors to media or even normal human ethicism or principles. One is vulgarism. Second thing is violence. And third thing is obscenity and depiction of immorality or impresent or improportionate depiction of morality. These things are also other brotherhood defects inside that. So vulgarity, violence and obscenity must be totally prevented, and there is also a pretext. It is known as pretext of the story structure. What is it known as? Pretext of the story structure. The story is like that, so we have to show. This is the excuse of most of the people. How it is there? Even if you have to show, there is a decent way of showing it. You must not show more cruelty. Prolonged depiction must not be done. Detailed depiction must not be done. Close-up shots must not be made. This is the morale of even the story structure where you have to do these things. What is the impact of these things on society? It has created a new faculty known as imitative criminology. What is imitative criminology or media tutorial? Media tutorial and imitative criminology is on seeing the cinemas, instead of learning that it is unethical or the villain is shot dead, the person will natively or naturally think how to do the same villain's work and not to get killed. That becomes the crooked mentality or intellect of the viewers or spectators. They want to be the villains or do something. And if there is some mistake in the villain's depiction or execution in the cinema, they try to avoid it. So the crooked intellect of the society wants to do the same activities, prohibited heinous activities, with a safety mechanism or safety engineering methodology of criminal executions. So they want to derive a safety engineering technique for doing their criminal activities. So in this situation, as the society is very immature for selection, option, abdication and accustomation, in this stage we have to tune things as per our own moral and ethics, not as per the demand of the society. This is known as media ethics. generally we used to call it as media ethics. And we used to have Pratyekika and Aneka. What is Pratyeka? Exclusive channel for exclusive things like Samskar TV and ESPN, etc. And we are having Aneka, means multidimensional or polystructural channel, in which we can have everything. We can have a slot, or we can have a mainframe, whatever it may be. These are all the various things involved now. I want to conclude this session by saying that what are all the things that are supportive of starting a new channel, and what are all the hindering factors, and how we have to proceed. These three things will be in the concluding session of my speech. Number one, public participation. If public is invited just to show their faces or speak there or dance there or demonstrate there, just to show in the space, just being inside the cyberspace or the telespace itself is considered to be a very great pride and prestige. It is considered to be a royal honor to the modern citizens of the country. So public participation, number one. Number two is incentives. Give lot of incentives. Even if it is an aluminium tumbler, if it is given in a stage, that has its own value. So the worthy element has its worthiness only on the area, environment and personality where the things are distributed, not on their market cash value or the cost value. So these things, they gain more benefit. So incentives. Third thing is temptation feast. Whatever the children they like, whatever the housewives they like, we have to feed them. That is temptation feast. That's what now going on. The fourth thing is staging. That is known as icon staging. The more icons are staging inside your telespace, more it will be visualized by people and appreciated by them. There may be two types of icons, ascendants and descendants. Those who are coming from the stage screen to the small screen, they are known as ascendants. Those who have come from the silver screen to the small screen, they are known as descendants. So these two people, they are known as icons, they are staged. So these things are the various possible methodologies. Temptation showering, staging of icons, as well as public participation with more incentives. That's what we are doing now. And for that we need money and also political favor, support and machinery. There are a lot of politically favoring TVs. There are a lot of supported TVs. There are a lot of political machineries in the form of TVs as a propaganda tool at all. This is how the media works. And what are all the things that are there ethically possible by us, some unexplored but explorable and to be experimented and experienced regions that are there in the military industry. We have to see that. So it is a very powerful thing, and it is as vigorous as any other tool. Generally, negative things, they are getting more power. Positive things are not like that. To harm your finger, the fire will take only 10 seconds, but the burner will take 10 days for getting its effect. So this is the nature. So how to have a positive or powerful or ethical way, what are all the possibilities to get it in a media center, in a military area? We have to take a military impact or a military procedure or a warfoot methodology. Number one, infinity innovation theory. Infinity of innovation is, there are innumerable innovations in the world.